Hello, welcome to Chronic Illness. Today I want to tell you about a fantastic natural supplement for pain relief. This video is part of a series I'm doing on supplements that can help with the symptoms of chronic fatigue syndrome or myalgic encephalomyelitis and other chronic illnesses. Now, notice I said help with symptoms. Supplements are not cures. I see a lot of scams out there and snake oil salesmen taking advantage of desperate people and peddling products that claim to be a cure for ME/CFS. There is no product or treatment that can cure chronic fatigue syndrome, and I don't want to give anyone false hope. I just want to share the supplements that have reduced my symptoms. Now, just because they work for me doesn't necessarily mean you'll get the same results. You need to tailor your choice of supplements to your own body and needs. And remember, just because something is natural or a supplement rather than a prescription medication doesn't necessarily mean that it's gentle or guaranteed safe to take. Some supplements interfere with other medications or exacerbate other medical conditions, so clear it with your doctor or pharmacist first. That said, there is some hope to be had. I think it's highly likely you'll see improvement by using some of the products I mentioned, so I do encourage you to look into them. Just don't expect a miracle, you know? I'll also add that I have no affiliation with any of these products. They're just things that I've bought with my own money and I've seen good results, so I want to share that information with others. So in this video, I want to tell you about a fantastic supplement that most people have never heard of. It's the natural pain reliever and anti-inflammatory substance palmitoylethanolamide, or PEA. This is a fatty molecule naturally produced in the bodies of humans, animals, and plants. Your body produces more of it in response to disease, but when pain and inflammation are long-standing, your endogenous PEA can become depleted, in which case supplementation can provide benefits. PEA has been shown to reduce pain of many different types, including osteoarthritis, headache and migraine, muscle and joint pain, neuropathic pain, back pain, fibromyalgia, and endometriosis. It also shows promise for the treatment of non-pain related conditions like depression, immune disorders and allergies, and the prevention of neurological disorders. However, the research is still in its early stages, so more trials are needed before we can say for sure that PEA is a good treatment for all these conditions. PEA also increases the effectiveness of some pain medications, so it's often used in conjunction with more traditional pharmaceutical products to maximize their effect. Now, despite all the promising evidence, PEA doesn't work for every single person. Not everyone in the studies found an improvement in their pain levels, but you won't know whether it will work for you unless you try it. And I do encourage you to try it because the worst that will happen is that you won't notice a difference. Unlike a lot of prescription medications, PEA has virtually no adverse side effects. Many prescription pharmaceuticals can cause problems like unpleasant side effects, allergic reactions, dependence, and withdrawal symptoms upon cessation. But because PEA is a substance that already occurs in your body, it doesn't cause the same sort of problems as regular medications. So if you're someone who's hesitant to try new medications because you're prone to side effects, or if regular painkillers typically don't work for you, PEA could be a good option. Personally, I found that it's reduced the overall severity of my pain. At first, I wasn't sure if it was working. I thought perhaps there was a subtle reduction in my pain, but I attributed that to other things that had changed at the time. Anyway, I ran out of PEA a little while after that, and sure enough, when it started to wear off, my pain levels increased, particularly the muscle and joint pain. So I started taking it again, and I find that my pain levels are decreased. Now, PEA isn't used like a regular painkiller. It's a slow-acting product that has to build up to a certain level in your body before it takes effect. It can take 2 to 3 months of consistent use to notice a difference, and 3 to 4 months to reach maximum efficacy. So make sure you take it for at least 4 months before deciding whether or not to continue. It's also a good idea to keep a pain journal of your various symptoms so you can more easily tell if it's working, and start tracking your pain before you start on the PEA. The standard loading dose is 400 milligrams 3 times per day for 3 to 4 months. Then after that, you can reduce it to a maintenance dose of 400 milligrams twice a day. You can order PEA through a compounding pharmacy. Some pharmacies require a prescription and some don't, Unfortunately, if you get it this way, it costs about $100 Australian for a month's supply, because it's not discounted by the pharmaceutical benefit scheme at this stage. I hope that will change soon. I believe there's also a brand that can be prescribed to you by a naturopath or functional doctor. So if you see one of those, you might be able to get it through them. But that particular brand is not available for purchase by the general public. Luckily, I found a website that sells PEA for about a third of the cost of getting it from the pharmacy. The company is Novaceuticals, which I've linked below. You just order it online through the website, no need for a script, and they deliver it right to your door. You can also set up a recurring subscription so you don't have to remember to reorder it. You get an extra discount that way too. So that's it for today, just a short one. If this video was helpful, give it a like, and if you try PEA, let me know how it went for you, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye! It's the natural pain reliever and anti-inflammatory substance, palmitoylethanolamide, or PEA. Took a bit of practice saying that one. Palmitoylethanolamide.